Don't you guys just love waves bigger than Bitcoin? You have to be kidding me. This is so big. Even Jim Crane, my little bobblehead. No, I don't know if he does. Just the bobblehead. That's how you always, if you want to know like when to buy, you just, oh, no, okay. We're selling now. And also, you guys, may this please be a warning to you. Being a surfer, it's fun, right? Well, I this wave wouldn't be fun. This is not a fun wave. You would be pitched and eating a lot of that. But it's always fun when you're riding it, right? Well, you wouldn't really much ride that. It would be a quick ride. And down south from me, there's a place called The Wedge. It's pretty cool. And when that thing starts pumping, actually, people start dying. And the chart that I have behind me, guess what? It's Bitcoin, right? Bitcoin is in an ascending wedge, or as some people would say, a rising wedge. Any way that you look at it, well, however you want to look at it, some of you are like, it's just a bunch of squiggly lines. I don't get it. This pattern breaks bearish. I mean, well, the probabilities are there. It's a probability that it's going to go, that some people are like, what's bearish? What's bullish? It's going to go down. But it looks like we still have a lot more to the upside. But you didn't come here for Bitcoin. You came here for this one. Like, what is this? What is this magical thing that should break bearish, but chooses not to? And look at this chart. And I don't want to see you get pitched. Yes, I made a video way back here, 600, 700. I'll go into it. I'll show you. I'll show you where I think we are going with Ethereum. And also, do not be shocked, because crypto has always shocked me my entire life. Look, and when we have an altcoin season, which we have, and you're like, what is even happening? Yes. And I was teaching my high school kids today about wedges. And sometimes I'm like, yeah, they look similar to other things. They're like, oh, I see the difference. Look at this. And I was saying, if this just closes, give me one candle above that. Look, see that? Full candle close. Oh my gosh. The wedgie is strong. This was not supposed to break that way. And in my opinion, this is super bullish. Ethereum's like, F y'all, I'm gonna do what I want. And it did, my friend. And also, if you could not get into my high school class, right? You're like, dang it, I missed it by a few years. I have a course on all of this, many, many videos and many videos to come, teaching you about how to enter and exit. So if you would like, I'm running a special link down below. And also my 24-hour special sale is running down below. Today is it. If you want both of the courses, because I teach people how to bring products like this to market so you can quit your day job. And if you were a swing trader, you would know that, well, your buy signal came on back, you know, 2001, two, you got a full candle close, 2300. What kind of profit are you guys even, what you coming up with? Oh my gosh, 42%. 42% in like, what is that, a week? And just to think that this bull market, man, on altcoins is just heating up. And here we go. Coming in from Bloomberg, Ether hits 3,000 as Bitcoin's crypto dominance declines. Looks like the market cap is now under 50%. Have we ever seen this before? Huh. Actually, with crypto, history doesn't just rhyme, it copies. And some people are saying Ethereum, you know, you think 3,000 is good, 9,000, 10,000, they keep pumping this. And oh my gosh, you want to know how to lose a lot of money? It's that red banner right over there. Looks like Bill Gates and Melinda Gates, sorry, it's a new story, are splitting up after 27 years. You want to know what else you're going to have to split up, Bill, is half of your income. And these guys just keep switching spots. Jeff Bezos, still $177 billion. Bill Gates, fourth at $124 billion. So slice that in half. He's going down to what, number 20 richest men in the world? Now, back to Ethereum, because I got some bones to pick with you, ETH. Number one, transaction fees. So for all of you that are just like, gotta get me some of that ETH. Yeah, it's, in my book, nothing beats the Bitcoin. When it comes to crypto, the reason why I like Bitcoin, I'm pretty close to a Bitcoin maximalist, but I do favor a whole lot of other cryptos. So just let's set that one aside. The market cap of Bitcoin, look at that. But let's look at the market cap of Ethereum. Can you believe this? Just think about this for a second. Ethereum is now more valuable than Disney, MasterCard. That's just mind-boggling. I just don't like my cryptos to have a CEO. I am into decentralization. That's just me. And I don't like it when, you know, you have to change it from back in the day. You guys remember when ETH got hacked? Yep, that was a 51% attack. Has not happened on Bitcoin. Also, something that, like, differences about Bitcoin is people are like, oh, it's so slow. Well, that's because you can't have all your eggs in one basket. Because if you do, you're going to have some problems and someone's just going to bash your eggs. Is secured, a secured network. Bitcoin is slow because it has to secure the network. And I like Bitcoin because it's first layer. That's it. Okay, great. It takes 10 minutes. Fine. I'll take it. Just like we have some problems with gold, right? I can't just be like, oh, here, let me send it to you right now. It's first layer. It's pretty secure. Well, unless you're Charlie Munger, then it's disgusting, right? Charlie Munger hates Bitcoin. Well, maybe the rise. Disgusting and contrary to interests of civilization, like buying back your own stock. But we have good news because you don't have to, you know, well, this stuff's gross. You can't have this because we are going to have a digital dollar that can just be created out of thin air. If you guys want, hold on, I'll just read this. Digital dollar project to launch 5 U.S. central bank digital currency pilots, also known as CBDCs. Those are, now I've talked about on this channel about inflation and deflation, and I always have to like, you're like, well, which one is it, Bravo? Is it inflation or it's deflation? Well, big picture, deflation. You're like, no, don't say that. That's okay. We're here to argue. We're here to form our own thoughts, our own opinions. Now, when will it be inflation? And I'll tell you, when you get your digital dollar and these guys behind me in this private place, the Federal Reserve, that no one can go into, once they monetize the debt and start sending it direct to you, well, hyperinflation. But as right now, the Fed loans, okay? When they change that and they take their balance sheet and the Fed spends, well, the game is now over. And I will bet my bottom dollar, even though I have not wiped with it, I, Johnny Bravo, will be running to gold faster than you can shake a stick. Especially if you have a stick nearby, then that's fast. I gotta be really quick. But if you have to like go out, go to the tree, take the switch off, well then, you know, I have some time. But you better bet I will be running everything. I will have, see this? Nope, you will not see me holding this at all. And all it will take is for these guys just to go, you know what? This is a great idea. I think we are gonna do this. And here's a story, the new monthly stimulus checks, right? This is gonna get so easy. For families may continue for years, forever and ever. And then the Fed's like, wait, we have a solution. You don't even have to do that. We got you. I mean, imagine how many more Meet Kevin videos now that he gets to do because they can continue this forever and run for whatever he's running for now. Hey, Bravo, why don't you run for something? I'm running right now. I'm running out of California, so just calm down. And also, will I be running into Ethereum when that happens? No, I mean, I'll probably always trade it, but I don't like things with a, I like limited supply. I don't want companies to be able to, oh, let's make as many as we want. That's great, right? I want an unlimited, or I want a limited supply, like Bitcoin. 21 million, probably 7 million of them are lost. So you probably, you know, left over with me, what, 15 million? Sorry if I did my math wrong, 14 million, 13 million. Not that many. And also, I think when people, because this, we're talking about Ethereum, when things start to end, they seem to run back to Bitcoin. So just be very careful. Never financial advice on this channel. This is just what I'm doing. If you want to copy me, that's probably a terrible idea. Because I think I told you don't buy Doge under the same pretense of unlimited supply. I don't like that. I like limited. I like something that secures itself. Hence, I like Bitcoin. Now, the stock market is itching towards euphoria, warns analysts, B of A. And guys, don't ever confuse markets with brains, because usually they don't have any. But then they keep repeating themselves. I actually got this from Sven, his Twitter, and it's like, oh, the market's great. Look at this. It's safe. Nothing. It has to be a log, right? What happened? And then wait for it. Is that a crop? Nope. I think it's a log, right? You could just repeat these cycles over and over and over again. And go for it. Jump, little buddy. You're going to be perfectly fine. It's okay. We're fine. Okay, good. Oh, well, let's check again. And I don't mean to be the bearer of bad news. I just like to point out, hey, can we look at the past? Like margin debt versus year-over-year change and what happens when everyone and their mother is piling in. You're fine. You're safe. The log is perfect. It markets never go down. Things have changed this time, right? And then everyone loses their shorts. Actually, they don't lose their shorts. There's not a single short in the market. Man, everyone's just long. Market, Fed go burr, but it has to always go up. And this altcoin season is going to be crazy. I remember back in the day, we were like, I don't think we'll ever have another one again. I'm like, oh, okay. Yeah, I even was like, well, maybe not. You know, maybe that was just the things of the past. And oh my gosh, everything is just repeating itself. And just in case you wanted to see margin debt, here you go. Here's a visualization. That was a tough one. Visualization. Ah, I did it. Of margin debt. And how about people piling into this market like never seen before ever. But it's different this time, Bravo. And that's why I teach you how to, because right, swing trading. If you swing trade momentum, there is times that you're in and then there's times that you're out. But Bravo, when is this market going to end? When are we, and I've been saying, I think we're gonna have a blow off top. Been saying that for a very long time. Could be wrong. Oops. Like I just broke this. Sorry if I broke your ears. This was Svensson's. Here we go. Markets completely fell apart when what? I've talked about this 129 million times. The 10-year hit 3.2 in 2018. And do not think that when markets dive, they don't take crypto with it. They always have. Probably always will. I mean, look what happened in March. Back in, it seems so long ago now. You're like, whoa, what was that? What was that? When, what was Bitcoin at 10, 11, 12? And then just 3,800. So 3.2%. We're far away from that. I don't know if we'll see that, but you also have to think how much debt, how much trillions and trillions and trillions of dollars worth of debt that we now have to pay at a much greater interest rate. You probably wouldn't like it if you're home, right? You're like, shoot, hey babe, rates went up to 15% today. Get out the checkbook. And also, again, big picture, I think rates are going down. You're like, no, rates are going up. Pull back. Let's look. This is the monthly 10-year rates are going down. That's why I think that the digital dollar is a guarantee. I think the Fed will go burr and not in the way that you want. Then you'll have your hike. Then everyone gets what they want. Peter Schiff gets his hyperinflation. Everyone's like, gold goes through the roof. Although I do think in the short term, right? Short term, yeah, you might have that correction. And what will happen when they hit that? Which I don't know. I don't think so. I mean, they're going to correct pretty fast because that's what this whole economy is. Is what money is banks lend. And they're going to not lend. But let me correct myself. The people will not borrow at high rates, right? We are addicted to zero. So there you go, kids. We have warnings, right? Enjoy the surf. You're at the top. It feels good. It's euphoric. Just know there's always bottoms. And also don't forget I'm running that 24-hour sale down below. And when it comes to bottoms, when the tide goes out, right? And no one's wearing them, I want to make sure I have you protected. That's good, right? Protection. That seems good to me. Remember, gentlemen, always protection. Always. Come on. What does my little bobblehead say about using protection? Oh, yeah. Yes. Thank you, Jim. And thank you guys for hanging out to the very end. And I will see you. Hey, I do videos every single day. So I'll see you tomorrow. Maybe you should subscribe. Like, do something. Or maybe watch a video over here or over there, wherever it pops up, because you're really bored. You have nothing else better to do.